Hi, we're here at SHOT Show 2019 with Phil Cashin of Masterpiece Arms. Thanks for spending some time with us and our audience. And your products have become almost ubiquitous in the NRL PRS style matches, and you continue to innovate. You've got some new stuff, so let's talk about that.
Okay, great. So so let's check out this new chassis we have right here. So this is our ESR chassis. This was actually developed for a domestic military application that we were involved in a project that we ended up not being awarded. However, we had designed the chassis and we felt that we wanted to go ahead and bring it to the market. So the basis of the chassis is very similar to our comp chassis, full-size chassis. The fore-end has an additional 2 inches of fore-end length. Now, what's kind of been interesting about how the chassis has been kind of received by the long-range precision shooting market. You know, a lot of NRL and PRS shooters kind of really like the additional landscape here on the front of the forend. You know, a little bit more room for back management. You know, some attachments that you could use on our Arca Swiss rail, on the rat rail. The chassis itself, we're looking at additional 2 inches. It's got a variety of different night vision bridges on here that can be added based on the application, whether it's tactical shooting, law enforcement, military, etc. This is something new we just came out with. This is our spigot mount, and it actually integrates a Picatinny rail on the top side or a dovetail on the bottom. You can reverse it depending on whether you're running an Arca Swiss interface or a Picatinny interface. This chassis will handle up to a 1.3-inch barrel contour, so if a guy wants to run an inch and a quarter straight profile or using it for F-class or, you know, other applications where you're having a really heavy barrel profile, there's no limitations internally. For traditionally a barrel size, you'd be running with an action inside the chassis. You have the rest of the features on it are very similar to our previous product line. You know, the our rat rail that you see here, and you know, this is something that we developed back here a couple of years ago, and the market seems to kind of like that, you know, that Arca Swiss technology. And so, like, this is one of the pieces that we came up with here recently, a little accessory that's designed to be utilized with the rat rail. And so we call it a rat tail. And so what you would do is you would attach this to the bottom of the forend. You're typically going to use this thing in combination with a bag, like a game changer or similar type bag. And you can position it, again, anywhere along the full length. The way this thing is designed, you've got a handle on here that you can position up and down about an inch and a half in travel. You've got a forward angle and an upward angle. So the concept is, like, you get this thing and you start trying it out, you may find that the best position for you, based on your body construction and the type of bag that you're doing, your shooting technique, is up at the top forward 6 degrees. Well, then you would put this handle in that location to be able to be fine-tuned based on that shooter. And, you know, so when you can either use this as a primary grip, you can use it in combination with interfacing with a bag. It just really provides a lot of flexibility, plus being able to have the downward pressure of the shooter's weight in his arm kind of nestling the forend down into that bag. So it's just
so no more pressing down on your sunshade and...
Yeah, you're not having to grab your optic and potentially cause any, you know, point of impact shift issues. And it just, and again, it's you know, in this sport, I mean, there's so many subtleties that are specific to a shooter. Like, the way I shoot and the way you shoot may be different.
Right,
you know, and so, like, I may like it in a forward position, you may like it in an upward angle position. You know, our body types are different, the way we shoot, the kind of bags that we're using, etc. So, you know, like, with the rest of our product line, you know, you're trying to give the shooter as much flexibility as you can.
Yeah, and I saw the use case on this extended spigot over there. You put your Magneto Speed mount on there.
Absolutely. And actually, this is one right here. So this Magneto Speed, it's a really neat system. You know, the concept is obviously that you attach this to that spigot mount. Your Magneto Speed attaches to this rod, and it makes no contact with the barrel. You know, so when you're gathering ballistic data, your velocity information, then you're not doing so with potentially concerns of point of impact shot.
That'll mitigate, yes. We're very familiar with that.
Absolutely.
Very familiar. Now, I see here you have some scope rings.
Oh, yeah. So this is our new BA mount. And the basis of the design is very similar to our existing BA mount. However, we made some changes to the top caps and the profile. The profile, just to kind of give it a little bit of improved aesthetic value, but the top caps on here have a series of holes and bosses for attachments of supplemental rails. Like if you want to put an LRF on the top, or if you want to put an extended, like we talked about, flexibility for the shooter, if you want to have an extended rail on top here to engage the top of the rifle to pull it down while not touching the optic, it's going to give you that option as well.
And availability on this?
We're making them now. So we're transitioning all of the mount sizes over to this new configuration.
And the price on this?
$249.
And on this chassis that we just discussed here, availability and price?
Yep, we're making them now. They range anywhere, whether you want a folder or a non-folder, and depending on what kind of bridge you want, anywhere from $1,000 to $1,400.
Okay. And you've got another item here.
Yeah, so this is something, and it's amazing how, you know, sometimes you look back and you find a simple solution to a challenge that some shooters may have based on how they're running our chassis. And so, you know, depending on the type of height you have in your cheek riser, the kind of action that you're running, some shooters had issues with being able to gain access to the center line of the bore during the cleaning operation. You know, you put a bore guide in there, you're running a Dewey rod in, they're having to lower their cheek riser down or pull it off, or depending on what the circumstances are for that shooter. And so wouldn't it just be easy to be able to just pull this thing off just like that and not have to worry about it? Well, that's kind of what we came up with. So, and the solution is simple. We modified this threaded component, you know, that adjusts the rise and fall of the cheek riser. We have embedded an earth magnet down inside this board area.
Okay.
You've got this floating rod right here that engages that earth magnet, and you've got this notch right here that allows the thumb wheel to rise and fall the cheek riser. So you simply put it back in there, you get the holes lined back up, snaps in place, and you roll it up and down to your set position, and then you use it, and when you want to take it off, you pull it out, do what you're doing, put it back in, and you're good to go.
And can existing owners have their chassis retrofit?
Of course.
All right.
Yeah,
all
absolutely.
Right. All
yeah,
right.
That whole backwards compatibility thing, you know, I mean, this is an evolving market, but there's so many changes to the technology that we're all using as shooters now. But, you know, one of the things that has been key to MPA is, like, we don't want to kind of disregard, alienate our older customers. So, like,
right.
if your chassis is 4 years old, then you can utilize the technology that we are developing now on your older chassis. Worst case scenario, you may have to send it in, like, if that Arca Swiss rail, our rat rail. Like, if yours didn't have that, you would send it back into us. We charge you $50, machine it, and send it back to you.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, so that whole, you know, the backwards compatibility aspect of it, you know, you don't want somebody to regret buying a product from you thinking, because like a company like ours that continues to evolve so quickly, that they may be buying a piece of outdated technology, and we don't ever want our customers to feel that way.
Now here's another interesting widget. I know this comes from another manufacturer, but you're incorporating that?
Well, so what you have here, let me get this power. So that's just a little an extension for the mag release, but this particular mag cache right here, if you can kind of see what you have in here, there's a little slider plate, and what this position does right here, that interfaces with the tab on your mag body. All right, so like if you're shooting a Savage, you're shooting an Impact, and I'm shooting a Curtis, and Brandon's shooting a Defiance, you know, because of the different configurations of the mags that you're using, whether you're using like an MDT mag or a Magpul mag or an Accurate mag, they all have subtle differences. And what this slider plate does, it gives you the position set by the user based on that application of how high you want the magazine up into the magwell interfacing with that particular action.
Yeah, especially those AW double style. I mean, you need to get that geometry just right. But do you provide these or?
Yeah, this is our design.
Okay.
And again, so for your older chassis that's several years old, just knock that dowel pin out, put this thing in, and you're good to go.
Okay, good to go. So did I make a mistake when I said somebody else?
They make this piece right here. So
Another
of our associate companies has made this little piece, and it's just a connection to go on to the bottom of the mag cache to give a little bit more real estate for engaging the mag release on the chassis.
Okay, I got you. So that accoutrement here,
That comes from another manufacturer. Actually,
okay.
Brotherhood Arms is the one who came up with this.
Brotherhood Arms.
Yep.
Okay, excellent.
Yep.
And I don't know, is this kind of impromptu, or is this one of your offerings?
That
here?
Is that. Well, we're going to talk about that, but that is not one of our offerings. One of our team shooters, a guy by the name of Troy Lawton. Troy came up with this grip, and he uses it on our chassis rifle that he used, shoots in the PRS. But it's just, I mean, we think a lot of Troy, and I think it's a really great product that he has right here, but it's just a different grip because of the TLC grip, and not only will it work with our chassis, but other chassis out there that have, you know, this A2 interface for, you know, whether it's an MDT or an XLR or other chassis out there. But it's a really great grip, Troy Lawton TLC grips.
Excellent. And then I know you've had this out since the last show, but just as a reminder, since you showed the MagnetoSpeed mount, you've got...
Yeah, so this component right here actually is made by Matt Yor of Sawtooth Rifles.
Ah, okay, and, we know Matt.
Oh, Matt's a great guy.
Yes,
and,
yes.
So when we saw that, we called him up and said, hey, can we interface that with one of our rat bases? Because with our utilization of the MagnetoSpeed kits, we think it's a great way to display your readout for the shooter to being able to gain his data and not have this thing flopping around on the ground attached to the rifle. So Matt's a good guy, and we think a lot of his products, and we're glad to work with him on that little collaboration.
Can they procure these from you, or should they go to the Matt?
With our rat base, it'll come with us, and of course, I think he sells this base unit that may interface with ours and other ArcaSwiss base plates.
Okay. Well, you have a lot of stuff here on the table. Anything you want to draw folks' attention to here?
Well, I think we've covered a lot today.
Okay, excellent. Yeah. Well, Phil, we really appreciate you spending time with our audience, and best of luck at SHOT Show 2019.
We appreciate it.